Masters of Biotechnology in RMIT.
That I feel is pretty expensive, useless, unnecessary also.
So you can start like your course with that specialization if you have figured it out, what you want to go.
Master of Biotechnology, Master of Biotechnology specialization in food science, forensic science, clinical. If you do really well in the internship, you can get a job directly from there as well. One more interesting thing is you can start a business.
Hi guys, hello everyone, welcome back to another vlog. This is KapsLock with Rushri in RMIT campus. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
All good. So first of all, thank you for coming. And this video is related to something which is quite popular and quite being asked in the comments and Instagram DMs and everywhere, which we call Masters in
Biotechnology.
Right. Is it engineering or is it just biotechnology?
It's everything.
It's everything?
It's everything.
It's everything. Okay. Rushri is going to explain. She's doing Masters of Biotechnology in RMIT campus for one semester. Is almost done, right? The assignments are about to be here.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Pretty stressful.
Pretty stressful. Yeah. It's just assignments are assignments. We can't do anything on that. But yeah, it is what it is. Okay. So we are going to talk about the course. But before the course, two basic questions. Let's start with the first. It's not a question, it's just what you feel, okay? And before starting the video, just be honest, just be what you are, informal, and give whatever the feedbacks you have, the advice and whatever you exactly feel that the person should know, okay? So the first question or the first point is, why Australia?
Okay. So basically, people who do bachelor's in biotechnology, that's generally a three-year course.
Uh-huh.
So after doing a three-year course, Australian universities have, like the high-ranking universities do accept students having a bachelor's of three-year course.
Mm-hmm.
So unlike US and Canada, which ask for a one-year postgrad diploma.
Okay.
So that I feel is pretty expensive. Useless, unnecessary also, because like we do like we gather enough knowledge in our bachelor's that we can directly start our master's
in the same field.
Yeah, in the same field. Okay. So that is how, like, Australia was giving me the right high ranking university. Uh-huh. I was saving my time basically.
Makes sense. Yeah. Those were the reasons why you chose Australia. Yeah. The next point is, why RMIT after choosing Australia? Did you research and
why
did you choose RMIT?
I was actually confused between RMIT and Monash, to be honest. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Both has the courses, the same course?
Yeah, same course.
Okay.
But I chose RMIT because of, like, purely because of the course curriculum. It has the best course curriculum.
You researched on that?
Yeah, the course. I chose on the basis of course.
Okay.
It's like Monash had more of medical biotechnology, but RMIT covers everything.
Okay. So biotechnology is not only medical, right?
Biotechnology has food, it has like environmental, marine, everything.
Okay. And so after checking the curriculum, how did you check that? Okay, this is the current and this is not the current.
So, yeah, like Masters of Biotechnology in RMIT covers all the sectors. Like it covers food, environmental, it covers computational biology, everything. So it's like it is divided in 2 years, right?
Yeah.
So the first year they give you an overview of every sector. So you know, like, what are your interests, what are not your interests. You can figure that out in the first year.
Makes sense.
And then in the second year, you get to, like, the third semester, you get to design the course accordingly.
Mm-hmm.
So you study all of the courses. For example, if you are interested in food. So in the third sem, you can choose the food subjects.
Oh.
So like that, you can design it accordingly in
then
the second part.
Get your pathway, which segment you want to specialize
in.
Oh, okay.
Like that. And if you already have figured out, like, you want to go in food or forensic.
From the first
semester. Or clinical,
And then
Before even
starting the course.
If you've already decided that you want to go for forensic, clinical or food, there is this thing called Masters of Biotechnology specialization in so-and-so.
Okay. So you can start your course with that specialization if you have figured it out, what you want to go in.
So it's four options. Master of Biotechnology, Master of Biotechnology specialization in food science, forensic science, clinical.
Okay. And you're doing it?
I'm doing the basic Master of Biotechnology.
First, you're going to, in the first sem or second sem, you're going to check which one you're going to go with.
Yeah.
Oh. That's a pretty good knowledge to understand. Thank you for that, by the way. So the next, now comes the basic questions, and don't be nervous, it's going to be easy. So first, what's the fee structure?
Fees comes around, like, for the entire course, it comes around $80,000.
Mm-hmm.
But I got a scholarship of 20%, so my comes around
$64,000. $64,000 for two years
entire course.
Yeah.
It comes around 4,000 per subject.
4,000 per subject. Yeah, me. Yeah, okay. But it's always changing. So
yeah.
I would say the basic knowledge which she's going to give is going to be the same. Just but with the fees structure, make sure to visit the website because, you know, it keeps on changing every semester and every year. So stay updated on that. The next point comes with how the lectures are. Be honest. How the lectures are, how the professors are, how you feel when they reply on time, when you not, or yeah.
So this is a STEM course, okay? So everything is research based, like research papers, papers. So every week they pick up a research paper.
Mm-hmm.
They bring an overview of that. They discuss that research paper.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly it is self-learn. It's like if you can do it on your own, there's no need to attend the class.
Is it
like, yeah,
but I would say attend because you're paying so much money, right?
So it's like you can go attend the class, you can get that overview and then start on the research paper. It will help.
Okay.
But if it is difficult to manage, practicals is something that is very important to attend rather than the lectures is what I think.
And RMIT does provide practical and theoretical knowledge. Monash didn't.
Yeah, Monash also does.
Monash, but it's just
Monash is more of medical, I feel.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
It's not covering everything. And I wanted to figure out my interests also. So
you have the particular window in the first and second sem that you can check which one you
It's like the course that RMIT has.
Uh-huh.
It has a proper pathway.
Mm-hmm.
First year, it will show you everything. Third sem, it will give you the opportunity to design your course, like
and
choose the selectives accordingly.
Will, yeah.
And the last semester, you can choose the research project or you can go for industrial. That also, they have an option. So it's like dry lab, wet lab, all of that options they have.
So I exactly don't know the particular terms because I don't know much about this course, but I'm getting the main idea that how you can go from one place to another, second place to another.
Yeah.
So that's a good part.
That's itself the course pathway. So.
Yep.
It takes you forward.
Okay, but we'll talk on that on the next point, which is how the course structure. What's the course structure of this course?
Okay, so the course basically includes mathematics, computational biology, the normal microbiology stuff, genetics, proteomics, genomics.
Oh my god, I don't have fingers.
Yeah. So it's like you'll get four main subjects
uh-huh.
in the first semester and the four in the second semester. So that's like that you cannot change. That's the fixed subjects.
That's a fixed, yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
Everybody will study the same.
Even if you're enrolling the first semester, you need to take those.
Yeah.
You can't drop one thing.
Okay. You can design it in third semester.
But you can have credit transfer as well if you have studied
you
something in the first semester. That goes with every subject in every course. But yeah, makes sense. And
but it's like there are new subjects.
Mm-hmm.
Which you will have to work on.
Mm-hmm.
It's something you might not have studied before.
And assignments?
Assignments are tough. Very tough.
I would like to know more on that.
It's like assignments are more of your interpretation on that.
Uh-huh.
So it's like they will teach you, they will tell you the topic, everything. But what is your point of view on that?
Okay.
That is what all of our assignments are.
That's what matters exactly.
Yeah, it's like everybody, like you will be given a topic. So what is research? You research on that and then you come to a conclusion. So what kind of research do you opt for? What kind of methodology do you opt for? How would you do things differently? All of that we have in our assignment.
So in a research,
so like
you need to implement your own ideas and then you need to figure out how the things go.
Yeah.
And then you need to present in the assignment.
Yeah.
That's how the curriculum works.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's like individual opinion.
A person who does not like reading won't like it, right?
Won't like it at all.
I'm talking about myself.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Okay, the next thing is, after doing this course, what are the future pathways are like? I mean, the person can read from website, but still if you have...
So like I said, this is a very major field, like very vast field. So it depends on what your interests are. If you're into food, you can go into quality control, quality analysis and all of that. If you're more into technology, you can go into like bioinformatics.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like based on the medical data, you can do the data analysis and all of that.
Uh-huh.
One more interesting thing is you can start a business.
But how will the business be in future pathway after this course?
It's like we have a subject, biotech and business, which will be
what,
next sem, so I can tell you
what
after
what kind
that.
Of business?
There are so,
exactly. Like a chemist job?
Very basic, I can tell you is COVID vaccine, that's a business.
But we can't make it, right? We need the proper...
No, yeah, but it's like a COVID shield.
Mm-hmm.
So all of that, it's like a company develops that.
Uh-huh.
and the company sells that. So but company has a team. So there is the so one, owner one owner who started
it. But so, problem is, you need so much money on that, right? And you need a whole team for this. But still, you can, I mean, it's just a pathway. Yeah. If
but
someone has,
like,
you can go
that's for it. That's very, the most I'm telling you. Thing. But you, it can be very basic. Like, people, students basically do start all of that. Like, back in India, I saw people doing that. They do fertilizing, like, they sell fertilizers, like, build their own fertilizers and
stuff. We can do that with this course.
Yeah, it's like you, they teach us how to do all of that.
Okay, so some of the selling parts they teach.
Yeah, it's your idea what you can develop. What you can create.
But most of the part will be in the quality check, forensic and all, like
yeah,
a team member. There's 10% of the chances that you will be a business owner.
Yeah, it depends on what you can think of.
And where you can go after this.
How you can start.
Good point. Are you gonna think of, are you thinking of doing a business?
Probably. Yeah, why not
she
give
has
it a
answer.
Thought? Why not give it a
why
thought?
Not? Yeah. Yeah. The last question is, so here comes the main, not the main, but core structure was the main, but this is the last question, which is PR, permanent residency. Whatever you know, whatever you've heard about this course, if someone wants to stay in Australia after doing this course from RMIT, what are the chances, what are the steps?
I think PR is more based on the point systems and all that. But if I speak it like in general sense, in the sense like, would you get a job or not?
Yes.
So that way RMIT I feel is has a great outreach. Like few days back only I met the placement cell head of my department.
That's good.
That's through events, by the way. Should attend all the events. So I met her and she was telling me how she reaches out to companies and how all that system works. So it's like they're working pretty hard for our placements. So it's
correct.
Like, yeah, you have to build that skill and you have to do all of that to reach there. It's like RMIT has opportunities, you have to take that. So it depends on that. Also, in SEM 4, there is this industrial project that we have. You can choose for a research project as well or industrial. So if you go for industrial project, that is the opportunity you can build connections. And that's like an internship. So if you do really well in the internship, you can get a job directly from there as well. Yeah, so
that's a good
one. That is like one of my friend has got that.
And he's doing good in this
field.
Oh, okay. So it's just you need to connect to the correct people.
That's
what
RMIT will give you an opportunity in semester 4.
Yeah.
You need to take that.
Write it down. After doing the job, the person will need to just follow up the basic rules, the skill assessment and all, right?
Yeah,
because you need to check whether your job role comes under the skill assessment list. Then you can check whether you will be available for the future steps to be a permanent resident in Australia. Okay, last part. It's not a question, so be honest, be whatever you think. How's your personal experience in RMIT in Australia? Anything you want to talk about? And what points you don't like yet about RMIT?
So, obviously there is more of I like this, I like that.
Let's go with the like first.
Events. Best events. And then the course is also very nice actually. It's just if you're interested, it is very nice. But if you're not interested, it's a burden.
Oh, so choose it wisely.
Yeah, wise. And like the faculties are also very helpful. You just send a mail and you'll be answered right away. That's all very good. Something that I don't like is traveling to Bandura. I have to do that twice a day.
I can't help it, but yeah, it's still okay.
It's just my course, so.
So I feel the same for this because I live way far away, but still when I want to come, I come. But yeah, makes sense. And what do you don't like about the university exactly? Or any particular course or curriculum that you have seen yet?
I think this only.
That's only, this is a travel part.
Yeah. And apart from that, maybe like they do the overview of the research thing. It's like, I feel if it's like more, explanatory? It would be helpful. But it's more like a discussion rather than an
explanation. So you want it,
it would be
improvised in a form that a teacher will be explaining what the research is, not just discussion. Okay, this is the overview, let's discuss. No, you want it to be an explanatory part.
Because there are some people who are not having the same background.
Makes sense.
Yeah, it's like some of them are from food science, or they might not have the exact knowledge of
that particular
biotechnology.
Okay. Then they need help in that.
Yeah.
Okay. Good point. Okay. So this was it. She's Joshri from RMIT in Melbourne City campus. I'm mentioning her Instagram just coming up there. So if you have time, make sure to reply to the comments or messages. And also whenever you get time, you can comment down below too. Whenever you get time, come back to the same video and reply.
Okay.
Okay.
Sure.
And my Instagram is also in the description. If you have any questions, if you want a video on any other topic or any other segment, keep us posted. We'll make it. And thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Like, share, and subscribe. See you guys in the next video. I'm going to shoot so many videos today, I guess. But yeah, so this topic is covered.
Bye-bye.